terms of wins.
Long fast serve straight down the line. Ovtcharov takes the lead. I've always felt the Germans have a really good team spirit among the men and the women. They've got Richard Prowser now, who sits above both the men and the women, and then you've got Jörg Roskopf, who looks after the men's team.
One lap.
And I think no one will be more disappointed about Timo Boll not playing than Timo Boll. And the fact that I suspect Ovtcharov is only fit enough to play one game, or he's only confident that he can play one game well. Because he made it very clear at the beginning he was getting back to fitness and was hoping by the end of the tournament he'd be in some sort of shape. Maybe feels he's not quite there. But he's certainly prepared to give it a go in one game, which seems a very admirable position to take. And of course, if he wins this, then it gives Germany two chances to make it through to the semi-final.
Yeah, I mean, there's two ways of looking at it, isn't there, Don? And I'm with you there, you know, but I can also see the fact that, you know, if he's fit enough for one, then you'd imagine, well, obviously he's not fit enough by his own declaration, I'm sure, behind the scenes. You know, I'd love to be a fly on the wall in the sort of, you know, the pre-team selection, because he would be a man that you'd always have down for two, wouldn't it? But obviously, as you're implying, he just doesn't feel like he can do it, so... There we are, but...
I don't think he's moving quite as fluently as he can down there, even now.
Yeah, and of course, these guys, as a former world number one earlier this year, they've got to look at the future, the long term, you know. Super forehand received from Suboy. His 11th showing at the World Champs. First one was in Zagreb in 2007. He's got plenty of miles on the clock in this kind of occasion. Oh, blissful from the man in black. He's carrying off on where he left off last night. Set the place on fire with his performance against Tomislav Puchart, who's down two games to love and 9-6 down in the third game as well. Terrific comeback from him.
Interesting that the Brazilian team will have looked at the lineup before they knew the German lineup, and they'll have decided we need to win three games. How are we going to do that? Best two chances, Calderano wins two. They've got to play him in the A or A, B, X, Y. Mm. And then where's the third best chance of a win? It's to play Suboy in the middle. Mm. They're thinking Boll, Ovtcharov, one and two, A and B, X and Y, whichever it is. So their best chance is Suboy against one of the other German players, Steger, Franziska or Felis. So that's their plan, to win three. And then, of course, they get the team sheet, and lo and behold, Suboy is playing Ovcharov. That's the last thing they expected
yes,
to see.
True. Yes,
but, you know, the guy's 8-5 up. He's played really well. Definitely, Ovcharov is not moving like anything like what we know he can.
Twice before these two, and Ovcharov has won both times, once in 2008 in the Kuwait Open, and in the Men's World Cup in Paris 2011. But as you say, it's slightly tainted by not entirely fit Dmitry Ovcharov. But Suboy, can he make hay in that regard? With spin, that serve. Such a quirky delivery, but so effective. So two game points then. The former world number one. Always kissed the edge there, Suboy.
Still one game point remains for Ovcharov.
Super play. Look at that, how he snatched that point, that critical point. So, back for the second game then in this third match. Ovcharov off to a flyer. Took the opener convincingly in the end.
Anticipated by Ovcharov, that long fast serve into his backhand, he was waiting for it, picked it up nicely, good strong backhand topspin on the diagonal. backspin on the Ovtcharov serve.
Terrific little push from the man in black. That was perfectly weighted. Causing indecision from Ovtcharov, right? The second bounce almost on the table. Vicious from Saboy. Good start again from the Brazilian, as he did in game one. But eventually the slightly edgier quality of the senior ranked Ovtcharov shone through. Oh, that's beautiful.
What a great shot there. Just leant on that a little bit and then elbow and wrist, and the ball whizzed away. Have a look at that again. Here it comes. Strong player there from Ovtcharov. Good backhand to win the point.
And this is what happened last night. Once he gets inspired, suddenly very, very dangerous.
Playing very clever, Saboy. He's pinning Ovtcharov down the backhand, occasionally wide to the forehand. Tying him down. I'm not sure Ovtcharov's quite got the range of movement that he would like. But certainly full marks to Saboy, dealing with the situation as it is.
Hemorrhaging errors right now, but it's not unforced errors because of the quality coming off the racket of this man. Gets a lot of body rotation into that serve as well. It kind of helps.
Oh.
is nibbling away at the Brazilian score here. Desperate to get back level. From Ovcharov there, really exploding cross table with all he had. And what was it, 9-4 just a couple of minutes ago, and now suddenly.
So we're ready to recommence after the timeout. Tsuboi with his second serve in this sequence of two.
Long, and he got it where he wanted it, and he had a crack at it, but
missed by millimeters. Mm.
So what's that, 9-4, five in a row for Ovcharov? Outstanding pass to play.
Caught the top of the net. Yeah.
But as you say, arguably millimeters in that regard, really. Such are the margins that these top athletes are playing with. Hear what it meant to him there. Stopping the run of points to five for the German then, Tsuboi. Now, can he win the biggest of points, the game point? Off the Ovcharov serve. He can, and a big choy at the end of it. 11-9, he takes the second game to draw level. Good work from him, having lost that heady lead, but he found a way in the end. In this third pivotal match in the overall scheme of things. Massive acceleration he's getting out of that backhand side, the left-hander. Really can just suddenly go on these runs of points. Indeed, they both can. It's sort of swaying all over the place, the momentum within this. But rewarding for some brilliance, there's no doubting that. Both men very quirky with the way that they apply their trade. But so far, equally effective.
I don't think Ovcharov's got the movement. The wide serve to his forehand, then the next one wide to his backhand. I'm not sure if we'll see that on the replay, but that just didn't seem to be Ovcharov at all. Mm. Just that movement, quick movement from side to side.
Yeah, in and out of the corner of the table. Corners of the table. Oh, hang on, the ball's popped across from the Sweden-England clash. Sweden with the strangle head there. There's a replay of that.
So there, and then just seemed to stretch more than he would normally do. There wasn't the movement. Great to see that on the replay. He's certainly not complaining about anything, Ovcharov, but that's the professional that he is.
But you would imagine the Brazilian coach being very perceptive will have sort of picked that. Certainly Tsuboi is not short of experience either with all of his 32 years. He'll be aware that something's up. Oh, nothing wrong with that, though. But again, I guess critics would argue it wasn't quite wide enough from the Brazilian. Blistering attack, and so early.
That's a clever return of serve. It looked like the flick was going middle or forehand, but instead angled it deep into the backhand. Threw it up a little bit.
Serving him really well, excuse the pun. Moskov delighted. So, taking care of his own deliveries very well of Turov there. Just nudging ahead marginally. Can he create some more daylight?
Now beginning to play some great shots.
Yeah, it just looks like he's found his rhythm. And really sort of sweet timing from the rangy German there. Serve just oodling everywhere, unable to control the Brazilian that one. Good response though, big body blow there from the lefty.
Tight return of the serve here. Good flick by Shoeboy there.
Yeah, he's super agile, isn't he? He's not carrying a lot of weight, so he gets up over that table really quickly when he gets the nod. Look at that. Within 1 point now of a heady 2-1 lead in this critical match. Bookended in the middle of the overall tie. Yeah, he does indeed secure the game for 11-7 and goes 2-1 up in this race to three. Dima Ovcharov in the driving seat at the moment. One match win for each nation. This is match number three. Ovcharov with the lead here, 2-1 in this race to 3 games. Can he get across the line?
Got it!
He really is the bedrock of the Germans' weaponry. And it's been hard for Savoy to really, really make a consistent run of points. That's a beautiful flashing backhand. We saw a lot of that last night. Very late, approaching midnight it was when the match finished. Ovcharov with his multitude of different serves proving problematic for the Brazilian. Competitive fourth game, this, as we anticipated. He's not giving an awful lot of ground, Savoy. Really digging deep. And this is what happened last night. You know, he was two games down in that final match, third and fifth and deciding match, and he managed to pull it around commendably. It was terrific work against Pucar of Croatia.
Four, two.
Luck there for Dima, and he heads slowly to the towel to take his time and increase the scoreboard pressure on his opponent. Just an indication there of how much spin was on that ball.
Heavy batsman, middle of the table. Savoy had to push, he pushed, and then Ovcharov in with the topspin. Ovcharov now looking, again, a good strong forehand topspin this time, well placed into the body of Savoy. Excitement on the adjacent table is Sweden have just beaten England. They're now through to tomorrow's semi-final. They have the pleasure of competing against China. Meanwhile, Ovcharov 7-2 in the lead, looking good now for Germany to go 2-1 up in this quarter-final. And indeed, a little bit of backspin on the return of serve from Ovcharov. And that now makes the score 8-2, 3 points away from securing victory. Good topspin again. This time, Ovcharov threw the ball up. Didn't go for the fast topspin, but good variation, winning the point. And indeed, 9-2. second towel break of this fourth game. I suspect the final towel break, but you never know. And so we now have 7 match points for Germany to take a 2-1 lead. And that forehand topspin down the line just misses after a gutsy performance by Suboy.